Hello everyone, this is Reeta here with the next lesson or the next video on Western Gangas, which is very important from KPSC point of view. So that comes under Karnataka history for KPSC, that is prelims cum mains. So in the previous videos, we have dealt regarding the Kadambas, their architecture, their literature, their education and also the religion. So in this video, I'm going to deal with the Western Gangas, that includes their architecture, literature, religion and education. So friends, if you have any doubts regarding KAS guidance or any KAS material, you can browse through the website, that is KAS Moksha, which is an initiative of Inspiro IS and KAS, or else you can call or WhatsApp to the number which is present on the screen. So let's start with the lesson. So as we see the Gangas, so we call these Gangas as Western Gangas. So these Western Gangas were the contemporaries of Kadambas. So after Kadambas, we could see they ruled for major period of about 6 centuries. So their capitals, so initial capital was Kolar, which was called as Kolahala. And the next capital was Talakadu, which was on the banks of river Kaveri. And the third capital of the Western Gangas was Makunda, which was near Channapatna. So as I have told you, whatever the dynasties we are learning, so it is very important you have to learn the capital, their emblem and the important rulers to write it in the introductory part of that particular answer. So if we see the emblem over here, so the emblem of Western Gangas is the musk elephant. So here a doubt or question arises, why we call this Gangas as Western Gangas, not as Eastern Gangas. So why? Because so this dynasty is referred to as Western Gangas to distinguish them from the Eastern Ganga dynasty that in later centuries which ruled over Kalinga. So here we see Western Gangas ruled over Talakadu and this Eastern Gangas ruled over the Kalinga. So that is what we differentiate Western Ganga from the Eastern Ganga. So here we see the capital, their emblem and the period for which how many centuries they have ruled the ancient Karnataka. So next important thing we need to see is about the rulers. So the first ruler was Dadiga, who was the first ruler of the Gangas. And next after Dadiga, it is Madhava I. His son came to the throne. He was an able administrator and he was a patron of scholars. And next we see Durvinita, who was among all the Gangas, has been famous for his valor, his scholar and his patronage of art. So among all the Gangas, who was the ruler who is famous for his valor or scholar or patronage? So he was none other than Durvinita. And finally, we see Rajendra Chola, by capturing Talakadu, put to an end to Ganga rule. So the Chola rulers was none other than the Rajendra Chola. So he has put to an end to Ganga rule in ancient Karnataka. So this is all about the rulers. So that includes Dadiga, Madhava I, Durvinita and finally Ganga rule was put to an end by Rajendra Chola of Chola rulers. So next it is very important now the main part of the lesson, that is architecture. So if you see the architecture of Western Gangas, so this was influenced by the architectural features of Pallavas and also the architectural features of Chalukyas of Badami. So the both architectural features we could see in the Western Gangas. So if you see the Ganga pillar, so the Ganga pillar with conventional lion at the base. So if you see the right side picture on the screen, you could see the conventional lion picture on the base and a circular shaft of the pillar on its head. So if you see particularly about this picture, so you could see the conventional lions which were at the base and a circular shaft of the pillar on the head of this lions. And you can also see the square pillars and the stepped vimana of the shrine with horizontal moldings had been inherited from the Pallavas. As I have told you, the architecture of Gangas was influenced by Pallavas. So which of the features they have taken from Pallavas? So they took the square pillars, the stepped vimanas with the shrines and the horizontal moldings. So all these features were inherited by the Pallavas, from the Pallavas by Western Gangas. So next we see the construction of monolith of Gomteshwara was commissioned by Chavundaraya constitutes the climax of Ganga's cultural contribution in ancient Karnataka. So which is the last culture or which is the last cultural contribution in ancient Karnataka by the Gangas? It is the construction of monolithic statue. So which is the largest monolithic statue in the world? And this construction of monolithic statue of Komteshwara, so who commissioned it? So it was commissioned by Chavundaraya. So this marks the climax of Ganga's cultural contribution to ancient Karnataka. And also we see, so not only this monolithic statue, we can see many other temples, the Chaityalayas, the Basadis they built are found in many places. So if you see the Jaina Basadis, so these Jaina Basadis, they have the tiny shrines which have the engravings of Tirthankaras. So all these Jaina Basadis, they have the shrines so that are engraved with the Tirthankaras. So if you see the example of these Basadis in Karnataka, we see Chavundaraya Basadi, which was built in 10th or 11th century, Chandragupta Basadi, which was built in 6th century, and Panchakuta Basadi, which was an excellent example of Dravidian art form. So these are the examples of the Jaina Basadis, so which were built during the reign of Western Gangas in ancient Karnataka. So here you need to remember the monolithic statue, which was commissioned by Chavundaraya, and many other Chaityalayas and Basadis were built. And what are the examples of the Jaina Basadis that have the engravings of Tirthankaras? So next, if you see the Gangas built, so not only the Jaina Basadis were there, but also I told you there were even temples and Chaityalayas. So if you see the temples, the Gangas built several Hindu temples with splendid Dravidian gopurams containing stucco figures from Hindu religion. So if you see here, not only the Jaina Basadis were there, but also there were Hindu temples with Dravidian style of art. So as we know, there are three styles of art forms, that is the Dravidian style, the Nagara style and the Vesara style. So among these styles, so this Dravidian art form contains the gopuras in the temples. So this particular feature also we can see in the Western Gangas architectural form. So if you see the examples of this, Boganandishwara temple at Nandi, Vishnu and Shiva temple at Nalsamangala, Kolaramma temple at Kolar. So these are the three famous temples what we could see, so which were constructed or commissioned during the period of Western Gangas in the ancient Karnataka. And also we can see number of the hero stones they have left behind. They represent another legacy of Gangas. And we can also see the memorials containing the sculpture details of war scenes during this period. So not only the temples, not only the Chaityalayas, not only the Basadis, but also we can see some of the heroic stones. So that has the sculptural details of the war scenes which took place during the period of Western Gangas. And also we can see Hindu Saptamatrikas and the Jaina Tirthankaras also. So this is all about the architecture we need to study. So once again I revise. So here you need to say by which of the architectural features it was influenced. And next, we need to tell about the important statues and the Jaina Basadis. And next, we need to speak about the Hindu temples which were constructed or built during the Western Gangas. So this is about the architectural features. So coming to the literature and education. So if you see, Gangas were the patron of literature and education. So many of the works were written in Prakrit language, Sanskrit and even Kannada. So if you see a few of the works which were done in the Western Ganga period, they were Sri Purusha, who was a king, who wrote Gaja Shastra. And next we see Chavundaraya, who was a minister, so he wrote Chavunda Purana. And Durvinita, so he wrote Bruhat Katha. So Bruhat Katha is also critic in Kannada. So next we see Pujapada Devanandi, so he wrote Shabdavatara, that is the grammar. And next we see Nagavarma, so he wrote Chandoma Buddhi. So these are all the works which were written in Prakrit, Sanskrit, different languages, that may be the Prakrit language, Sanskrit language and Kannada language. And also we see which are the important places of learning. So Agraharas, Mathas, Jaina Chaityalayas. So these were the important learning centers. So education was compulsory during this period. And we see technical education was encouraged. So the study of the religion and the logic were most predominant during this period. So here, this is all about the literature and education. And it is very important. You need to know at least 3 to 4 of the authors and what their works are. So I mean 3 to 4 poets and their works. So this is all about the literature and education. So next we see the religion. So what was the religion of the Western Gangas? So they were the staunch followers of Jainism. They were religious tolerants and they always enjoyed the faith, or they always enjoyed equal status. All the faiths were considered to be equal, all the religions were considered to be the equal. So if we see what are the main religions that were followed by the Western Gangas, they include Jainism, Buddhism and Hinduism. Especially in Hinduism, we see the Shaivism. So but Buddhism did not become as famous as Jainism because many of the kings, they followed Jainism. So Buddhism did not come to such a big light during this Western Gangas. So here we could see the Buddhism, but it was not so prominent as Jainism. So we see how we can come to know that Jainism was famous religion, or the main religion that was followed by the Western Gangas, as we have seen in the architecture that we could see many of the Jaina basadis. So likewise, we see here one example, that is King Shivamara. One, he developed various Jaina basadis, and not only the religion, here we see many of the love of impression of the otherworldly pioneers also we could see in this religion. So next we see the love for the subordinate gods also. So here in the religion, they were religious tolerant, they were the main followers of Jainism. They also followed Jainism, Buddhism and Hinduism, and also they followed from few of the world pioneers, example Bhadrabahu and Shravan Belgola, and they also followed few of the subordinate gods. So if you see the subordinate gods, this Yakshas and Yakshis, we see the subordinate gods, so who were being worshipped during the Jainism and also many other kingdoms of North India. So all these things were the religious aspects of Western Gangas. So this is all about the religion. So this is all about the lesson, that is Western Gangas. Hope you like this. Hope you understood this. If you have any suggestions, please note it down in the comments column. And if you like this, please do share with your friends. Thank you for watching. So next lesson I'm going to do on Chalukyas of Badami. So that lesson we'll see in detail. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.